In this video, I'll share my autosomal DNA test results with you. At first, I bought a kit from AncestryDNA, and after receiving my results, I downloaded the raw DNA data and uploaded it to other websites to check what they might say about my origins. Now, before I tell you where I am from, please try to guess what my ethnicity is. Those who know about racial phenotypes can share their thoughts as well. You can stop the video right now and share your thoughts in the comment section down below. Okay, now, I am from Turkey, but I am not an ethnic Turk. My father is basically a Kurdish man from Eastern Anatolia. In these days, almost everyone knows Kurds, but for those who don't know, Kurds are Indo-European people who live in Middle East and Caucasus and who speak an Iranian language called Kurdish. On the other hand, my mother is of Kartvelian and Bosniak heritage. Kartvelian is an umbrella term, just like Indo-European, for Georgian, Laz and Svan people. We know that her paternal side came from Georgia, but we are not sure whether they are Georgian or Laz. And Bosniaks are Slavic people who live in Bosnia and Herzegovina. Here are my ethnicity results, according to AncestryDNA. I am 71% Caucasian. By Caucasian, I mean from Caucasus. Actually, I already knew that the Caucasian will be the most dominant percentage of my ethnicity estimates because both Kurds and Kartvelians are dominantly Caucasian. Still, this is more than what I expected because the average native of Caucasus is 83% Caucasian, which means I'm almost as Caucasian as an average native of Caucasus. The second dominant region is Italy, Greece with 18%. This is also not surprising because the Asia Minor was a Greek land for thousands of years. Also, some Balkan Slavs genetically can be closer to Greeks than they are to East Europeans. The third largest component is Middle East with 8%. Then comes Ireland with 1%, which is surprising because I play Celtic music since my childhood without any knowledge of any Celtic heritage. This Irish blood may be from Galatians who settled in the central Anatolia, or maybe from Crusades. It's impossible to know for sure. Then I have less than 1% East European and again less than 1% Ashkenazi. Ashkenazis are European Jews who live in Eastern Europe. These are probably from my Bosniak side because, after all, Bosniaks are also Eastern European. The last two components are Scandinavia and North Africa, both are less than 0.5%. These results also are not surprising because we know that Varangians went to as far as Black Sea and even Iran, and North Africa is not so far away geographically. According to DNA.Land, I am 100% West Eurasian, but West Eurasia has many subcategories. I am 82% Central Indo-European. This is the same thing with AncestryDNA's Caucasus component. In the description it says that Central Indo-European component includes Circassians, Armenians, Iranians including Ossetians, Anatolian Turks, Kartvelians, Chechens, etc. The second component is Northwest Europe with 5.2%. The samples are from Norway, Scotland, Iceland and Orkney Islands. Then I am 3.6% Balkanian, 2.8% Southwestern European, 2.1% Mediterranean Islander, 1.6% Finnish, 1.4% Ambiguous Central Asian and 1% Ambiguous West Eurasian. MyHeritage displays your ethnicity with a beautiful short video that plays the native music of each geographical component you have. Let's watch it. İsmi Sirkan This is a picture of family tree DNA. it displays their autosomal DNA percentage from different Neolithic European populations. They divide Neolithic Europe into three different populations: hunter-gatherers, farmers, and Middle-Asian raiders. Roughly, hunter-gatherers were settled in Western Europe, farmers in Southern Europe, and Middle-Asian raiders were the Proto-Indo-European or Yamnayan people who came into Europe from Eurasian steppes. According to family tree DNA's ancient origins feature, I'm 55% farmer, 34% Middle-Asian raider, 9% hunter-gatherer, and 2% non-European. Okay, that's it. Thanks for watching. If you're interested in the European studies, veganism, theology, or Celtic music, please subscribe to this recently created channel and check my other videos.